It's so much fun, these pieces of shit on intervention. They're just, man, they're such losers. They have forgotten the rules of the party. They just take it to the nth degree. Like, dude, no, that's too much. Nobody needs that shit, right? I know. I mean, I just think it's just, I don't know. I think they're fun to make fun of. Like this one time we saw this girl, she's a mom, and she had three kids just like us. She's a single, fat, blonde mom, and me and the kids were like, ooh, we're going to be able to relate to her. That might be fun. And then, because we don't relate to anybody, because we're so weird. Anyway, so then we're watching this show, and she is digging through her own garbage like a hobo. Ugh. And she's getting the last little bits of vodka out of her trash, and then she's dumping it into a glass and then mixing it with like Listerine or some shit, and then, you know, shooting it. And my son Christopher is just disgusted with this. He goes, oh my God, she has three kids, Mom. What is she doing? Why doesn't she just have one of her kids make that cocktail for her? I was like, shit, Christopher, you get the corner office. Fucking genius right there. What are kids for if not to make your cocktails? I don't know. I haven't done my own laundry since 1995. My kids are my bitches. They're lazy as fuck, but they shit their pants when I walk in a room. So we're watching the show more. Okay, so the woman like does like one of those confessionals where she's just looking at the camera and she's crying and she's hysterical. But I think she's on to the show. Like now she knows that this is intervention, right? Because she's like, I'm an alcoholic. You know what I mean? She's just kind of making eye contact with the camera guy like, And she's like, I sure wish I could get some help. Like, maybe I need to go to rehab and get away from these fucking kids for a hot minute. Right? Like, maybe somebody needs to help me out. And the camera guy does one of these jobbies. He's holding the camera, and I had to rewind it several times to make sure I was right, but I was right. He did this. He goes, like, oh man, this is awkward. Oh. Like, free rehab is a week away. But I can't put down my camera and tell you that and give you the help that you so desperately want because I've got to get another week's worth of B-roll of you going through your garbage like a hobo. You have not yet cried enough, lady. I will not help you. But I'll totally help your ass in a week. You totally... as soon as you get ambushed by your family, by Melty Face or the fake Dr. Phil, you're totally going to get some help. I told the kids, though, I said, this bitch, she's not an alcoholic. I said, I am an alcoholic. Your mom's an alcoholic. And the kids were like, well, you've never had a DUI. Hey, they're smart. I said, well, no, because if I get a DUI, I have to stop drinking. I'm not stupid. An alcoholic knows you don't fucking get a DUI. The kids were like, but you can't be an alcoholic. Like, even my oldest son, Christopher, he goes, you've always taken care of us. You've always made sure that we had food and clothes and gotten to school on time and had everything we needed. And we got good grades and nothing's ever been a real problem. And I said, yeah, because if I don't do that for you guys, a judge will tell me I have to stop drinking. Are you not following me? What do you guys think this is about? And then I said, no, no, no. The truth is, this woman on the TV doesn't love booze. She hates herself. There's a difference. Mommy loves booze. Right? Like, I love drinking. I love drinking culture. I love the way it makes me feel. I love the way it makes me bring comedy to the masses. Yeah. You're welcome. I had a child molester move in next door to me. Yeah, that's gross. I know. You know what, babe? Don't worry about it. The child molester never fucked any of my kids. You know, they didn't go outside. So it was not ever an issue on the table. And a lot of parents got, like, when he moved into town, like, everybody freaked out in the neighborhood. When everybody just lost their shit, except me. Because I was like... like, how's this guy even going to know I have kids? Is he going to, like, smell us while we're waddling to the car to go to Burger King? Is he going to... And even if he did figure out that I had children, is he going to, like, come over in the dead of night and lift the window and drag one of the little dough balls out across the street? No. Come on. I told one of the PTA moms, one of the local moms that tried to get me to sign the petition to get him the fuck out of our neighborhood. She's like, you're not taking this seriously, Kristine. I am not. You are so... That is a right assessment. I don't give any kind of a shit about this dude. Like, he's gonna fuck your kid, not mine. Your kid rides a bike. Right? You worry. I don't want to worry. Even if he could get one of my kids, I told her, I said, I honestly, you know, if he thinks that one of my fat kids is going to suck his dick, they don't even eat broccoli. So, no. You know what, though? The worst thing about having the child molester in the neighborhood really was that, like, as everybody was just freaking out, and I was so cool as a cucumber, was that my kids could tell. When they were little, they knew that I didn't give a shit about that guy. And that was, like, very awkward. You know, imagine having these sweet, fat, chubby little kids, and they're like, Mommy, aren't you scared the bad man's gonna get us? And you just are like, oh, honey, he's just not that into you. You gotta ride your bike if you wanna, right? Like, you gotta work out. That's okay.